Hello, Bane Gang. So today will be a short little video. I've had a lot of people asking about the staff for the Bane Occultist, and I wanted to just make a video that fully encompasses all the different options that at least I have considered. And you can use this information to help yourself, you know, upgrade your character. You know, with that build, there is kind of this ceiling that you eventually do hit, roughly around the 2 million DPS level, where a staff is just what you got to do. And you know, in all of my examples, I do show the fractured staff that I've had. In fact, I've actually had a few different fractured staffs over the history of me playing this build. You know, with the change of supply and demand, fractured bases are just kind of tricky to get right now. And a lot of people don't know how to fracture themselves, how to, like, what fracturing really even is, maybe not even know about the options that they can have without fracturing. And I wanted to present like a wide array of budget options and what you can look at and what you can do to continue upgrading your character without relying on trying to buy like a 30-50 exalt fracture, because there's only like one up on the market. This is my staff that I had last league. This is my occultist that had almost 20 million DPS. This is kind of very, very close to perfect endgame staff. There's a little bit of improvement that you can get here, but this is just, I wanted to show what can be possible with some knowledge and with some money. If you want to shoot for this in the extreme future, I'm not recommending this. This cost me multiple hundreds of exalts, but just so you know, like, this is possible. We can push the damage to this build to pretty extreme, crazy levels if you really love the build and you want to stick to it. And I am playing much more conservatively with this build, this league, because I want to play a different build, play other things, get this build to a place where I'm really, really happy. It can do all the content that I need it to do. And that's also a really nice thing to just have as a goal or something that you want to do when you're playing a build. It's just like, you don't always have to be upgrading, right? Like, you get to you set your goals, you want to like kill the feared, kill Maven, something like that. And then you're like, okay, the build has accomplished what it needs to do. I'm happy with it. And for me, I have roughly 8 million DPS or so at this moment. I have killed the feared. I am very, very happy. I spent a total of roughly 30 exalts on the staff. And that's only because I like overpaid on the fractured base. I wanted to start off with something, you know, I just wanted to buy it, get it over with and be done. But you absolutely could make your own fractured base or even a similar staff for significantly less. So what I am packaging with this video, and basically what we're going to be looking at for the extent of this video, is a spreadsheet that I just made this morning showing the different options, going from a low budget, like effectively 5 exalts or fewer, perhaps even 0 budget if you get lucky, all the way up to the option that I just showed you guys that could go between 200 and 500 exalts depending on your luck, and everything in between. So what we're looking at here, for the very, very low budget option, you can make a staff that has +3 level or +2 level of chaos spell skill gems, and the +2 level of all skill gems, and maybe some spell damage, and maybe even some chaos dot on top of that if you want to. This can be effectively free, honestly. What I'm recommending here is just get a staff, throw it into random, every single harvest that you find. Reforge Chaos, Reforge Caster. The reason we do this is because the two hard to get mods that we're looking for both have the caster tag, and Chaos has the Chaos tag, and a little side bonus is Chaos.multi also has the Chaos tag. So, you know, the odds are not extremely good, but there are a number of folks in the Discord who have been showing off staffs that they've made by just throwing it into Harvest, and this is entirely possible. Just, you know, have a backup staff. You know, you could buy a 6 link, eye level 77 to 80. You don't want to go below 77 or above 80, because that's that sweet spot where you have the highest chance of hitting the mods that you want. And that's going to be true for all of the staffs that we're going to be crafting today, or talking about crafting today. So if you're between 77 and 80, throw it into random Reforge Caster, Reforge Chaos, and you have a decent chance of hitting something that you're looking for. The odds of hitting the +3 Chaos are pretty low. The weighting is pretty rough on that. It's only 100. It's not the worst, but it's half as good as +2. But if you just hit +2 and +2 of the two levels, get a little bit of spell damage on there, a little bit of Chaos dot multi, it is a significant upgrade over the Cane of Unraveling. So I recommend, even if you hit that, a +4 level is still really, really good. You don't need to go for the +5 level to have a very, very strong build. Alternatively, you can use these two fossil combinations to try to get a force of going for this. Now, this is optimized for going for the +2/+2, not the +2/+3, but that's still really, really good options, right? You're looking on average 619 chaos to hit roughly this combination or, you know, with the tier 2 chaos dot. And if you want to just force it, right, like that is significantly cheaper than looking at the fractured, you know, 20, 30, 40 exalts that, you know, the alternatives that people are looking at. The reason I'm showing the second option here is because this one includes the aberrant option. The cool thing about the aberrant option is it actually increases the chance of getting the chaos dot multi. You do have a lower chance, you know, you can see by that price there. Oh, sorry, let me scroll down. You can see by that price there that you have a, you know, 50% lower chance of hitting, you know, what you really want to hit in terms of the +2/+2 or +2/+3. But because we have aberrant in here, we actually have an increased chance of hitting chaos dot multi. So you can get a better option if you really want to, if you want to spend a little bit more, but still like 600 chaos to hit a +2/+2. That's a pretty solid option for, you know, not doing anything particularly crazy. Now, this is our absolute low budget option. If you are very early starting on, you hit that ceiling where you want to upgrade your staff. For fewer than 10 exalts, you can get a nice staff that will take you all the way to Killing Maven. Now, this is the medium budget. And immediately, we're going to be looking at fractured bases after this. This is where it's really going to shoot up. What this is, and this is kind of like where I was going with Last League when I really wanted to upgrade the build and take it to the next level. When I found this, Last League, you could buy these bases for 2 exalts or, you know, 2 to 5 exalts because there was just no demand for it. This is really all about supply and demand. If the build becomes popular, you know, and the supply is basically staying the same, you know, the demand is the demand is going to push that price higher. But we can still buy fractures ourselves. The price of buying a fracture is still about the same. But we've also had a lot of questions about what even is fracturing in the first place. Now, what fracturing is you'll see that the modifier here is kind of this golden beige color. That means that it is fractured onto the item. It means the item can no longer become synthesized or influenced, but that modifier can no longer be changed whatsoever on the item. That means that any other rolling that we do, essence crafting, fossil crafting, it won't remove that modifier. That makes it a lot easier if we have the like a difficult to hit modifier fractured on to just go for the other ones, and we can just target specific mods, and we don't have to worry about, you know, also hitting an additional hard to hit mod, right? So what we're doing in this case is we're trying to fracture on the all chaos spell skill gems, and as with the previous option, all of these options we're looking at eye level 77 to 80 staff. Not a war staff. I also want to make it very, very clear. A couple people have gotten bamboozled with war staffs. In the game, there are two different types of staffs, staves, whatever you want to say. Staff means that it is, it also is for casters, is primarily for casters. It will have spell things, increased spell damage, stuff like that. War staff is for bonking. It's for, you know, doing cyclone attacks, stuff like that. It has a totally different mod pool. It doesn't have spell damage. It doesn't have what we're going for. Do not buy a war staff. Do not be bamboozled by that. We want an eye level 77 to 80 base staff. And particularly, you want one of the bases that is specifically 18% chance to block attack damage while wielding a staff. We can see what those staff bases are. We can just go to the emulator here, click two-handed weapons, click staff, not war staff. They are two different modifier pools here. And we just want to go down to, we actually don't really care about anything. You know, you could even do a gnarled branch if you could find one at eye level 77. The only thing we care about is the implicit, because the only thing that changes other than that is the amount of physical damage. And we're not attacking, we don't do any physical damage. So you're totally valid doing something like an imperial staff, or a primordial staff, quarter staff. These are all totally fine to use as long as it's eye level 77 to 80. Because what that does is, you know, we need eye level 77 to at least hit that +3 level of chaos spell skill gems. And we don't want higher level than 80, because as soon as you do that, it adds a lot more modifiers to the pool and it makes it harder to roll. The options are either buy an already fractured staff. As I said, in the past, these were dirt cheap because no one cared about it. But now, because there's a build that's popular, people want it, you're not going to be finding that for fewer than 20 exalts, best case, I think. That's basically what it's looking like right now. So to fracture a staff yourself, there are two options. Because we are fracturing a prefix, there are two different ways to fracture an item. And they both come from the same source. It is from a harvest tier 4 seed, which means it's very, 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 very rare. Harvest tier 4 seeds are incredibly rare, to the point where I don't even recommend farming it yourself. It is just incredibly inefficient. Even if you have four watchstones and you're doing it in Haywork Hamlet and you have it mega, mega optimized, you're going to see best case like one or two a week, and it's probably not even going to be what you're looking for. I have done this in the past. I can speak from experience. Do not target farm this. You are way, unless you're an SSF, and in which case, you know, you gotta, I would probably just farm the low budget in SSF. The best thing to do, because you can efficiently, you know, make 5 to 10 exalts an hour doing something like Expedition. If you, you know, check out our previous video, my last two videos were actually talking about making a lot of money in Expedition. Check those out if you want to figure out how to make money. You know, make 5 to 10 exalts an hour and then buy the fractures yourself. Now, I am not going to instruct people about how to use the Forbidden Trove, but my recommendation is to, this is really just the best place to do it, use the Forbidden Trove. There's a lot of instructional material out there, but this is a Discord server where people do trades for a lot of different things. What you're going to end up doing once you join the Forbidden Trove, there's a whole, you know, you have to learn how to work with the community. You might have to get vouchers yourself, stuff like that, but you're going to want to go into harvest, want to sell. And then you can just do Control F here and type fracture. And then you can find the fractures that people are selling. You can see that fracture suffix is going for 8 exalts. You can see that fracture 1 out of 5 is going for 3.5. And then fracture prefix, let's see if we can even see one. These are the 3 different options. This is also going for 8 exalts. Now, these are pretty decent prices, actually. In the past, it's gone up to about 12 exalts. And what that means is you're gonna get either 3 prefixes or 5 total modifiers on your staff. You are going to whisper that person. You're gonna go to their hideout. You're gonna give them the staff. They're gonna do the fracture, and then they're gonna trade it back to you, and you're gonna give them the exalts. These are random. So 1 out of 3. So you need to have at least 3 prefixes. You can craft a prefix if you need to like finish it, but you need at least 3 prefixes for the 1 out of 3. And then you have a 0.33 repeating, of course, chance of hitting the modifier that you want to hit. You could just hit something garbage and it could be a bad staff. It's a 1 out of 3 chance. But with 1 out of 3 chance, it's really easy to just hit that modifier, you know, throw it into Reforged Chaos, you know, use Aberrant Fossils. Once you hit that modifier, buy a fracture, make that fracture. You know, if it's only 8 exalts each, or even 3.5 if you have 5 modifiers, that's actually really, really good, right? If those base staffs are selling for 30 exalts already fractured, you know, if you have a 1 out of 3, even worst case, right? Like 1 out of 4 is the number of times that you're going to hit for like really, really good odds. You're still basically spending about the same amount, right? Making the fracture yourself. Once you have that fractured base, I actually took these instructions from the previous Banecraft spreadsheet. You're going to use Shuddering Metallic Corroded until you hit +2 all spell skill gems. You may also already have the increased spell damage on there. If you don't, craft prefixes can't be changed. Do an Ashling Slam, tier 4 Ashling. Check out the Betrayal video if you want to know how to farm Ashling yourself. Once you know how Betrayal works, you can actually farm it yourself very, very quickly. I don't think it's worth even spending the 2 exalts on Forbidden Trove, but if you're impatient, you can do that. If she hits you, if she gives you a suffix, clean it off, continue. Otherwise, you know, just keep on going. Prefixes can't be changed. Reforge Chaos, hit Chaos Dot, and craft Chaos Damage if you have an open suffix on top of that, and that's how you're going to make your staff. How much you're going to spend depends on how unlucky you are with the fractures and all that. If you hit it your first time, you could craft your whole staff for 15x or less. If you're unlucky, you know, top end, you're hopefully looking at about 30 to 40x total. So that's my recommendation if you want to go for the fractured staff. I would really go for the chaos spell skill gem option, this medium budget option. In the end, it does end up being a little bit cheaper. But what I did this league is I went for the +2 all spell skill gems. This is pretty cool. This is actually my staff that I have right now. The Blood Bane, I actually like the name, is kind of nice. It kind of fits the build. So the difference here is similar idea. We want to fracture, either buy it already fractured, fracture it yourself, the +2 all spell skill gems. The cool thing about this is once we have that fracture, now it's harder to hit that modifier in the first place. Hitting that fracture is going to be annoying, but once we do have it, the fossil combination is actually going to give us, with a high chance, chaos damage over time multiplier. And then we can actually just end up kind of having a really, really good staff right off the bat. I actually hit tier 2 chaos dot just for my fossils. I crafted spell damage and I said I'm good. This is really, really cool because it gives us some alternatives. Like this fossil spamming is actually a little bit easier than with the other fracture. So this is an alternative if you want to go for this. You know, the instructions are all right here. feel free to ask questions in the Discord if you want to do this option. I did choose to do this intentionally because I think it's a cool, different way to craft the staff, and the finishing of it actually becomes easier and less painful. You're going to have a really good chance of not having to do the Reforged Chaos at the end to finish it. And as I showed at the beginning of the video, this is the highest budget option. So why is that? Now, I'm not going to go into the full instructions, and I figured, all right, we already got instructions about fracturing and all that written and all the other ones. Didn't write it here. Big thing here is we start from already fractured damage over time multiplier. Now you'll see that this is tier two. The reason why it's tier two and not tier one requires eye level 82, which as we said before, has a way wider mod pool. If we went for tier one, we're actually looking at like double the price of finishing the staff. And we're already looking at like easily 50 to 100 exalts. To fracture mine last league, I spent at least 300, maybe even more. I just lost count. So this is the extreme budget version. This is really, if you love the build so much that you want to make it, you want to get over 20 million DPS, you want to just show off, this is what you can go for. You know, I'm just showing this as an option. If you get to this stage, I do recommend you already know what you're doing. That's why I didn't go into a lot of detail for the crafting instructions. But basically what you do is you fracture tier two chaos dot. Go for tier one if you're absolutely crazy and you want to spend 1,000 exalts. But, you know, I ended up with tier two fractured. And then you're just gonna spend at least 10 exalts minimum on fossils. There's a good chance you're gonna spend more than that. You could easily spend 100 or even more. I did spend multiple hundreds until I got, I think this is tier two increased spell damage. I hit that and then I did prefixes, cantrip. So you're gonna be using those fossils until you hit plus five level and spell damage, right? So we have to use fossils until we hit the really, really hard stuff. And in fact, if you have not fractured base and you want to spend a lot of money, this is the exact same option, right? To hit the good prefixes. Use this four fossil combination, get your prefixes, and then prefixes can't be changed. Reforge chaos until you hit nice chaos dot. If you're spending this much, you're going to go for at least tier two chaos dot. And then, you know, look at your bank account and realize that you spent everything crafting a staff, but you will have something very, very nice to show off at your dinner parties. All right, hopefully this answers all the questions that you guys have had about crafting the staff and everything. I do realize that this build has been appealing to a lot of newer players and they aren't entirely sure of all of the different options that might be out there. And hopefully this really just helps you understand what you may be able to do depending on different budget levels and maybe even introduce you into becoming a little bit more comfortable in crafting some different ways that you can like kind of put together a similar item. So yeah, thanks for watching the video and everything. I really, really hope that you guys get excited about crafting and I'm glad that you guys are enjoying the build and I'll see you guys next time. Thank you.